at 8 a.m. Tune in for my view of this place I call home.
Community Radio.
89.5 WSKB.
Live from Studio 120 at Westfield Technical Academy, this is WCPC Channel 15 and 89.5 FM WSKB Westfield.
Welcome to Superintendent Spotlight. We are broadcasting live today from Highladn School. I think it's our first time broadcasting from here, and I'm pretty excited. First of all, it smells like tacos because that's what's for lunch today.
Is that what that was?
Yes. Do you smell it? It smells pretty good.
Yeah, as soon as I walked in.
Yeah. So it's making me hungry. And but I'm also admiring how the cafeteria was painted. The floors look great. This place looks pretty good.
It sure does.
Director of Operations and Safety,
nice job. Doesn't it? No, they're doing a really good job here.
Absolutely.
They always have, though.
Absolutely. And so as we look around, we see stations. It is STEM week, right? I have Susan Dargy to my right. We have Lauren Cadigan to our left.
And welcome.
STEM
Thank
supervisor,
you.
Right? So Science, Technology, Engineering, not the M.
So our math supervisor is at SRS today.
Right.
Kate Perez. Oh, that's good.
Yep.
That's
so the
good.
M in STEM is at SRS,
she
and she's
is.
Doing. They're doing stations there as well.
Yep, correct.
So they're doing something this afternoon because I know Amy Porter's going to from the Westfield News.
Oh, that's nice.
I think she's headed there right now.
Okay.
For the stations, but maybe not.
And then Susan is here, too, so
yes.
You're our director of curriculum instruction, sometimes guest host, and one of our favorite guests, Susan. I have Halloween
Thank
in the mind,
you.
So I can't help it.
I've been in training for many years.
Yes.
Thank you.
So as we embark on the day, on the morning, I see our Some kids are coming in for breakfast, but our high school students are here too. So who wants to let us know what's going on today?
Sure. So I can give you an overview of today.
Good. Looks fun, by the way, and I can't wait.
It is really fun. We have 7 stations set up here. Different students will be doing different things, all related back to STEM. And I think we're going to go around to each of them later, but you
we
have
are.
Things like painting leaves. You have kids touching the inside of pumpkins in sensory bags. You have kids exploding pumpkins. With
my favorite.
I know. Yeah. But they also, we added a new station this year.
Okay.
And it's Dancing Corn. And
I really want to see that.
It's really cool.
Dancing Corn.
Dancing Corn,
okay.
Yeah. And so our high school students, actually throughout this week, 45 of our Westfield High School students have, since Tuesday, have been going all over the city to different preschools and working with our preschool students to run these stations. So currently here are students in our biomedical innovation pathway. And so they're here to help facilitate. The kids love, the preschool kids love the high school kids, and the high school kids love the preschool kids, and it's a really great partnership.
And well, Lauren, and these high school students are here with their teacher, who is a Westfield High School graduate as well.
Yeah.
Right?
Yep.
All right, who's the teacher? Do you want me to keep us guessing?
I'm like,
so,
damn.
Aiden Chisholm is working back at Westfield High School this year, and he has come along with these students today.
When did he graduate from high school?
He graduated college last year,
so four years
before that.
So I was going to say, he's relatively, I mean, this isn't someone that you or I are had as a student. This is,
no.
Aiden's recent.
Yes.
Awesome.
Yep. And
awesome.
He's doing really
I'm trying
great
to decide
things.
If you're saying we're old or young. I'm not sure yet.
Experienced is the word.
Okay. Right. I can't figure
we're
out.
On the, remember, we're on that slope on the downside, right? Heading to the end of our careers.
Yeah,
right?
I guess so. That's so you're making it sound old, is what you're doing. All right. So we're very excited for the stations. I can't wait to the end. And you said so we're doing this with our preschool students really across the district this year, right?
Yeah, and even our Westfield High School preschool.
And that's new, right? Is that new?
That's new. We are, as we've expanded preschools, we've expanded this. Mm-hmm. We started this 5 years ago at Fort Meadow.
Right.
And then as we've added preschools, but what's new this year is also our Westfield High School students are going to, our engineering students are going down to the preschool, and they made games using engineering design concepts, using Tinkercad, using all of the software to build these games. And they're bringing them down and doing a carnival with our preschool students. So they're doing more of at the high school. So they're doing an engineering.
Let me ask you a question, because I did have someone say to me that is it too young to expose preschool kids to STEM? What do you think on that one?
I think they're exposed to STEM every day.
Every day.
I agree, right?
I think that's where you hook them. And, you know, Lindsay Ayers, our pre-K to 4 STEM coach, can speak to that. But we've seen preschoolers do launch logs, which are our engineering notebooks. Mm-hmm. We've seen them operate at this high level for their age. I think if you give kids a chance, they blow your socks off every
time. Right?
I'm pretty sure Bryn and Murphy, who are watching today,
have been
doing STEM since they were born.
I'm pretty sure.
Did you want to give them a shout out?
Yeah,
from
hi
today?
Bryn, hi Murphy.
That's awesome. And I'm certain, I don't think it's too young either, and that was my answer. And I think that what I said, kind of what you said, that you'd be surprised what our preschoolers can really do. And they're so smart. It's amazing.
So smart and curious.
Well, that's the big thing.
Let's capitalize on that.
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
And everyone can do STEM. And that's the point of STEM Week. To see yourself in STEM, whether you're in preschool or a senior year in high school, we want every student in Westfield Public School to see themselves
Absolutely.
As a scientist.
Because typically, for some, it's a scary topic, right? And I think that, you know, they tend to shy away from it, but there's no need to, right?
No need. And if I always tell kids, if you don't like this science, you just haven't found one you liked yet, because
right.
there's so many out there.
Agree. All right, so we're going to take a break in a minute, but before we do that, because I still smell food, Tiger's Pride Restaurant at Westfield Tech Academy. We're not there today, but they are open today for lunch. So their soups are Tuscan vegetable or cheeseburg chowder.
Ooh, that sounds good.
It does. And I know what I'm going to have for lunch today because I'm having lunch with the superintendent from Gateway Schools today.
Oh, Mrs.
At
Smitty.
Tigers Pride, Ms. Kristen Smitty. I'm not having the grilled garlic steak salad, but that sounds pretty good.
Doesn't it sound good?
Grilled marinated steak sliced and served on top of fresh greens with garden vegetables and mushrooms served with a lemon or oregano vinaigrette or your choice of dressing. And then the entrees today are a roast stuffed pork loin finished with pan gravy and served with mashed potatoes and glazed carrots. That doesn't sound bad.
Not bad.
Or fried calamari.
There we go. Now we're cooking with oil.
Fried New England calamari tossed with grape tomatoes and banana peppers finished with garlic cream and served with a marinara sauce.
That sounds delicious.
Do you like calamari?
I do.
Do you like calamari?
Oh, yeah.
Me too.
Anything from the ocean.
Ken, you like calamari?
I pass on a lot of seafood.
You
really?
Do?
Yeah.
It's a seafood thing?
Yeah.
Not a fried
I'm allergic to some of it, so I don't take any chances.
I wouldn't take any
don't
chances.
Don't take your
either.
Chances. Yeah. Right.
And then the sandwich special, this is what I'm getting, is the Cuban panini, pulled pork with sliced ham, Swiss cheese, pickle, and a garlic aioli on your choice of bread, served with chef's side and a pickle. My hope is that it's macaroni salad, in case you're wondering.
Oh,
the
macaroni salad is.
The bomb.
I can tell
it's
you, Stefan, I had that Cubano yesterday,
yeah.
And it is a knock right out of the park.
Oh, excellent. I cannot wait.
Yeah, and no, the salad is not what you just mentioned.
Oh.
It's not?
No.
They had to change it?
No.
You need to
the salad that goes with the Cubano.
Oh, it's not Mac salad?
No, it's not. No, but it's something that's really good.
Oh, well, that's
yeah,
okay.
You're going to like it.
That's perfect. All right, Pete is back in the studio. I keep doing it.
You were looking right at me, man.
I know.
Yeah, okay.
After 8 years, what do you want from
me? What are you going to do?
So, Ken, take us away with our first song.
Got a fast car, and I want a ticket to anywhere. Maybe we make a deal. Maybe together we can get somewhere. Any place is better. Starting from zero, got nothing to lose. Maybe we'll make something. Me, myself, I got nothing to prove. You got a fast car. I got a plan to get us out of here. Been working at the convenience store. Managed to save just a little bit of money. Won't have to drive too far. Just across the border and into the city. And you and I can both get jobs. Finally see what it means to be living. See, my old man's got a problem. He live with a bottle, that's the way it is. Said his body's too old for working. Body's too young to look like his. So mama went off and left him. She wanted more from life than he could give. I said somebody's gotta take care of him. So I quit school and that's what I did. You got a fast car. Is it fast enough so we can fly away? Still gotta make a decision. Leave tonight or live or die this way. I remember when we were driving in your car. Speed so fast, it felt like I was drunk. City lights lay out before us, and your arm felt nice wrapped around my shoulder. And I had a feeling that I belonged. I had a feeling I could be someone, be someone, be someone. Got a fast car. We go cruising, entertain ourselves. Still ain't got a job. So I work in the market as a checkout girl. I know things will get better. You'll find a work and I'll get promoted. And we'll move out of the shelter. Buy a bigger house, live in the suburb. So I remember when we were driving in your car. Speed so fast, I felt like I was drunk. City lights lay out before us, and your arm felt nice wrapped around my shoulder. And I had a feeling that I belonged. I had a feeling I could be someone, be someone, be someone. You got a fast car. I got a job that pays all my bills. Stay out drinking late at the bar. See more of your friends than you do your kids. I'd always hope for better. If
Thought maybe together you and me'd find it. I got no plans, I ain't going nowhere. Take your fast car and keep on driving. So I remember when we were driving in your car. Speed so fast, I felt like I was drunk. City lights lay out before us, and your arm felt nice wrapped around my shoulder. And I had a feeling that I belonged. I had a feeling I could be someone, be someone, be someone. Got a fast car. Is it fast enough so we can fly away? Still gotta make a decision. Leave tonight or live and die this way.
Live from Studio 120 at Westfield Technical Academy, this is WCPC Channel 15 and 89.5 FM WSKB Westfield.
So actually, we are live from Highladn Elementary School today.
Yes, we are.
And we, of course, are doing our live broadcast for STEM Week. We have a new guest. We now have Lindsay Ayers, who is here, and she was here last
week.
She's now just becoming a regular on the show.
Ooh.
She's going to be disappointed, but I want you to know that every song we play today, I'm going to take the mystery out, is currently on the top 100 of Billboard, so the year would be 2023.
Okay, I'm glad you gave that away.
Yes.
Spoiler
alert.
Yeah.
But no pulled pork today.
No pulled pork.
Sorry.
No.
Another disappointment.
Yes. Any fancy
for you.
Oranges?
Yes.
How, did you have the orange?
I did,
was
yeah.
it good?
It was great.
Excellent. So, yeah, so we here we are, and I know the preschool students are coming at 9:30, so Lindsay's going to give us a little, well, first of all, before we get to that, our previous guest, who's still in the audience over there, is it the audience? Whatever, we have in the cafeteria.
Well, sure.
Yeah.
Let's...
Maybe he was honored Monday? Did something happen?
Yeah, Lindsay? So Lauren Figge Cadigan received an award at the Massachusetts Project Lead the Way Fall Conference on Monday at WPI. And the award is the Massachusetts Project Lead the Way Leader of the Year. And there's only one in the whole state.
Wow.
It's a big deal.
It's a big deal.
And she was completely surprised.
She was.
We kept a big secret.
Yeah.
And Lindsay had put together an email with Flip, formerly Flipgrid, link so that we could have the colleagues that Lauren works with, some students, some of the teachers and principals, do a 30-second video clip congratulating Lauren.
So how long did we know? In advance.
Luckily, it was only 2 weeks. I don't know if Susan and I could have kept
it. That's pretty good.
I mean, everybody else knew that she had been nominated.
Right.
But
right.
Stefan and Lindsay and I knew that she actually was.
I didn't say
winning.
A word.
Yeah. No, that was really
good.
Lauren is really impressed by us.
Yeah.
That's good.
Well, and I'm impressed too, and I know that Sue Figge is watching.
Yeah.
And Ralph, and they knew, and Lauren still didn't find out. So I'm really
impressed. That's even more impressive.
That I know that.
Yes.
And it's because it's such an honor, and if you're a proud parents, and so
what a great honor.
Just well done. And
yes.
You know, Lauren has been in our district now, Susan, how many years?
Six.
And really, our science programming has come a long way. And now, Lindsay, as our STEM coach, pre-K to 4, how long have you been in this role, Lindsay?
This is year two.
Okay.
Year two.
But I just love the way where our science is going and the direction we're going. We're on projects. We're hands-on things. And I think that's really important for our kids, right?
Absolutely.
Keeps them engaged. Keeps adults engaged, too, by the way.
No, that's how we prefer to learn, too.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Lauren gave us kind of a rundown of what was happening with the high school students and what they're doing today.
Okay.
Can you talk to us from the other side of the table, the other end of the spectrum, the pre-K?
Yeah, absolutely. So for preschool, this is our third day running the preschool STEM stations.
And we're doing it at all the preschools.
That we have
in our district.
So on Tuesday, we started at Fort Meadow, and that was a whole day affair because you have all the classes coming.
Well, you have the morning and the afternoon session, too, right.
And so we repeated those same stations yesterday at Munger Hill. They have a new preschool classroom there, so we had 15 students.
How did that go?
It was great.
Nice.
It was great. And I have to say, my favorite part is the high school students interacting with the preschool students. Sometimes the high school students have more fun.
I think they do. But you know what they say, you want to learn something, teach it.
Absolutely.
You know,
yes.
And if you teach it, so we're reinforcing their knowledge. So this is a home run for everybody.
Yeah,
really.
And so we create the stations, but the high school students really bring them to life. For example, the Dancing Corn is a new station that we added this year.
I can't wait. I just like the third time I heard it, and I really want to know what that does. Yeah. Don't you?
Well, you have to get your dancing
first
shoes
thing
on.
I, Dancing Corn? Really?
Yeah.
All right,
yeah.
We're in.
Okay.
You're
going to
dance for us?
Well, we'll fake it till we make
okay,
it.
Okay, all right. Susan,
actually,
you dancing?
I'm a pretty good, actually, sure, yeah. To be honest, I'm a pretty good dancer. I am.
Well, we'll find
I
out.
I kind of resemble
so
Elaine
yourself.
On yes. Seinfeld when I dance, so you don't really want to see it. It's a little embarrassing.
Yeah, that's brutal.
Well, it's all about the students. We'll make sure we show them.
Yep.
But the high school students at Fort Meadow, I looked over, and the little kids were dancing, and they were dancing with the corn, because what happens in the jar is the chemical reaction of vinegar and baking soda causes the corn to literally dance. It moves up and down.
That's cool.
And so the high school students, you know, they started dancing, and the kids were dancing, and so that became really like a STEAM center, right? Because we had the art of dance.
Oh.
Yes. See what I did there?
Yes. Very nice.
So we'll see if that happens. I don't know. No pressure. No pressure.
I just want to see you all dance.
Okay.
All righty then.
Okay, now we're having a dance off live on the radio show.
Video or it didn't happen.
Video.
So true.
Well, we happen to be on the air, so
yeah,
I think we're
right.
going to get to
we're
see
gonna
it.
We're going to be covered there.
And so today we're doing those same preschool stations here.
And at Southampton Road, correct?
At Southampton Road School at the same time. They have the two classrooms. So the same stations are set up there this morning.
Right.
And those two classes will rotate through the same stations. Yep.
And that's in their STEM room.
That's
right?
in their
Could
STEM room.
Could you talk
room.
About the STEM rooms that we're developing?
Yes. So Southampton Road School had an extra classroom, and they turned it into a STEM room. So really, it's the messiest room in the school because that's how it should be.
Yeah. No, really.
But it's a great place, first of all, for storage of VEX. We have a lot of kits coming in through Project Lead.
Okay, what's VEX for those of us
VEX
who have no
kits
idea?
VEX kits are, I think the best way to describe them is Legos.
Yes.
Okay.
But
so.
Much smaller pieces. And so they build, starting in grade 3, they build with the VEX kits, and then they become even more complex. There's robots involved once you get
middle school.
To the intermediate school and beyond. So they're like Legos. And they're embedded in the project Lead the Way. Yeah, I mean, the kids get so excited. Yeah,
I might get a little excited now if I had Legos. Well, for those of us with ADHD, it helps. You can build something while you're sitting at a meeting.
So the STEM room there is a storage space, but also a space where teachers can they can book to bring their class there, and it's just a great space. You know, the students get really excited to go to a special room to do Project Lead the Way or to do their STEM activity.
With and some special technology.
There's a special, we call it the special package touch view.
Okay,
because
why?
It's too complicated. Well, because it has a motorized stand. If we were to name everything.
It has octopus software.
Look at you.
I'm learning.
Yes. So you'd have to really list like 5 things.
Yes.
So we call it the special
package.
You say
the full package there. Yeah.
Full
and
package. Wow.
It really started as a place to kind of try some new technology out. And we have so a touch view all the way to the floor. Which is great for the, you know, preschool students there,
kindergarten
students.
Right, because I have to reach up. Yeah, yeah.
Mm-hmm. And you just press a button and it lowers, it tilts, it goes full tabletop. So students can go around the side, and probably 6 to 8 students can interact at the same time on that touch view.
And the STEM room isn't used just by the pre-K kids, obviously, right?
The whole school. It's actually become so popular we have to create a sign-up sheet.
That's a good problem to have.
It is.
Mm-hmm. What are you seeing as the STEM coach, you know, with our new preschool programs in terms of learning abilities and science and all of that? How's it going?
I think the engagement from the littlest students is incredible. And I think if we kind of capture that and build upon that as they go into kindergarten, first grade, second grade, imagine what they'll be able to do by the time they get to high school.
That's terrific.
In their science classes. So just even the understanding of what is science? What is a scientist? What does an engineer do? You know, teaching them all of those things.
Is it ever too young to expose kids to careers, Susan, do you think, Lindsay?
Oh, no.
Never.
Never too young.
Nope. So that's another benefit. I mean, the preschoolers, they'll say, I want to be an engineer when I grow up. And usually you hear the popular, you know, community jobs. I want to be a police officer, firefighter. So now we're adding those STEM jobs. Just
from both not just boys, right? I mean, everybody.
Yeah.
You're getting.
Yeah. So that's another benefit I think we'll
see. Yourself in STEM and women in STEM. And I'm just being, you know, I know that's been a big push because it's, I think, and it should be, because I think past, historically, it was not.
Right.
And it should be, right? I mean, that's.
And I think having a focus in Westfield schools on STEM at an early age, I think that that will really help. Because we're doing it. We're not just saying, you know, girls in STEM and we support all of this. We're actually doing it.
Right.
Right. And along with activities like this, we have our Adopt a Classroom programs,
sure,
where we have people coming into classrooms from industry and businesses in the community talking about their career and helping students to see the relevance to the learning that they're doing. I mean, we've had some incredible success with Adopt a Classroom. I'm thinking of the one that you facilitated recently with the nurse.
Yeah, there was an OR nurse who
yes.
came to a fourth grade classroom at Southampton Road, and she created hands-on stations as if she was an educator herself, right? And
we
yeah,
love
so
that.
That was really inspiring. Yeah.
Yes.
So I think the units, the curriculum that we have for STEM lends
was
itself to
Project Lead the Way, really,
yeah,
to help.
Lead
just want to talk about that for a minute? I mean,
yeah, sure. So I always love to talk about Project Lead the Way. But I'll relate Project Lead the Way in STEM Week, because usually we come up with resources in Westfield, and we have teachers maybe sign up to do a special STEM project for STEM Week and things like that. And
but we do STEM all year, don't we?
So we do. So with that said, we just decided let's celebrate the teachers that are teaching Project Lead the Way. You know, they attend a training. They work really hard. So we have some Project Lead the Way balloons behind Susan.
I didn't even see those. Look at that. Yeah, PLTW.
That's awesome.
So they're kind of homemade. We put a sticker on them.
Oh,
and
that's nice.
We tied them with
a
glow stick.
You didn't get them at Big Y?
Yeah.
You didn't buy
low
them?
Tech. It's a little more low tech mm-hmm. sticker.
Dollar
That's
Tree
for
is
me.
Where we got
okay.
them. Yep. Yeah. And we were trying to figure out a way to weight them down without, you know, spending $3 on a weight for each one, because we had 40
so what did we
teachers.
Use?
So we used a glow stick because our
oh.
teachers are and students are glowing in STEM. So what Lauren and I, along with Kate Perez, we have been traveling around to just thank the teachers who teach Project Lead the Way, because they're doing STEM, like you said, Stefan, all year long. So we showed up at their classroom. Some of them were teaching. Some of them were eating lunch, knocked on the door, you know, gave them a balloon and said, you know, thank you for your commitment to this program.
That goes a long way.
It
really does. Mm-hmm. All right. So look, at that first song was Fast Car by Luke Combs. It was a remake mm-hmm. of the Tracy Chapman song. It's Ken's favorite song. So moving on. Kidding. We're going to next up again. These are all in the current top 100. I'm surprised I could find four songs that I could play because of the way our lyrics
sure.
have gone
say.
In words
Good
right
point.
Now.
Good point.
So let's take it away. When we get back, the students will be here and
yes,
we'll go to
will.
The stations.
Sounds
all right.
Good. Change.
Live from Studio 120 at Westfield Technical Academy, this is WCPC Channel 15 and 89.5 FM WSKB Westfield.
And we're back to Superintendent Spotlight, broadcasting live from the beautiful cafeteria and here at Highladn Elementary School, and in the midst of STEM week, in the midst of our amazing preschool stations with our high school students. What do we got going on here, Mrs. Ayers?
So this station is called Exploding Jack. So we have some pumpkins in the tray here. Maybe we'll give a little.
This is my previous favorite.
And they're actually just starting the station right now, so we're going to get to see it live. We are making a chemical reaction here. So we're putting baking soda in the pumpkins first.
Ken, are we? They can hear us.
And then I don't want to give it away, but
we'll
wait and see what happens. Maybe when we add vinegar.
We're gonna add a little vinegar to the baking soda in that pumpkin, and we'll see what happens.
Do you have a prediction?
I think there will be a slight chemical reaction that will induce the combination of that chemical mixture to overflow and come out of the head of the pumpkin.
That could be why it's called Exploding Jack.
Just a guess.
All right, here we go. We're going to add the vinegar. Squeeze it.
And
here it comes.
And there we go. Yeah. Awesome.
All right.
Nice job.
Nice job, friends. All right. Okay.
Right.
I think we'll skip over here to the painted leaves station. So over here, we're comparing what trees look like in the spring and in the fall.
Well, why don't we have one of our high? Want to introduce yourself?
Okay, my name is Tatiana.
And where do you go to school?
I go to school at Westfield High. I'm a junior.
Great! Thanks. Yeah. Thanks so much for helping us out today. And we've got a couple of our kiddos working. What do we got going on, Mrs. Ayers?
So we are doing a painting activity. We have a spring tree on the paper and a fall tree on the paper, and they're looking at these pictures here of a spring.
This was yours.
And fall, and they are using paint to create the correct colored leaves for each season.
Beautiful. Yes.
That's okay. He's being creative. I love
that's
that,
all right.
Desmond. Nice job.
He likes orange.
Liliana, what are you painting? You're painting the trees? Painting the trees. Nice job.
All right.
Is it time to dance?
Are we going to the dancing corn?
It could be time to dance.
All right, this is the station we were talking about earlier. This is the one that's gotten all the press so far. We've really built up expectations for dancing corn.
Yeah.
So I can't wait to see this.
So right now what they've done previous to this, they have added baking soda, and the kids have stirred in to dissolve the baking soda. So that's another cool science word they're learning. And they just added the corn kernels.
All right.
So again, perfect timing. We're about to see the chemical reaction.
So again, we're mixing. You know, we're mixing here. It looks like vinegar, baking soda, and the corn kernels to see what happens. Yes. And I can see why we're calling it the dancing corn station.
Okay, ready? Dance like dancing corn. There it goes. What happened? Look at
what's
it.
What's happening?
I don't know.
What are the kernels doing? Yeah, they're dancing. And if you actually wait and continue to watch, they'll continue moving up and down because the bubbles here are attaching to the corn, making them go up, and then the bubbles pop, and they go back down. You can even stir it a little bit more as well.
Pretty amazing.
Yeah.
Good stuff.
Yeah. Maybe next year we have to have some music here.
I was going to say, that's a great idea. Yeah. Maybe add a little flair to the dancing corn, right? Oh! folks, we you know, in too bad you can't see the faces of some of our kids,
yeah.
right? They're just so, you know, so excited and so engaged. And
they're the ones doing the activities
oh,
as well.
Sure,
so
sure. No,
even
I,
though
I,
they could get messy, make a mess, we want them doing as much as possible.
Yeah, definitely, definitely. And that,
messy's okay.
Messy's okay.
Right, yeah, absolutely. It is. And I think you told me that our next station
oh, yeah.
is going to be a little messier than usual.
This is
right?
for you, Chris.
Okay,
this
thank
is for you.
You.
So we have opened up the bags, which are containing different parts of the pumpkin. So we've got the stem, we've got the insides, we've got the guts. And then, of course, we have the whole pumpkin here as well. So the students are reaching their hand in a bag, and they are guessing what part of the pumpkin based on what they're feeling, the texture. And if they don't want to get messy, we have another option.
We've
where
got
it is in the bag.
Option
so
they B.
Can just
right.
touch around. Yeah.
Well, that sounds cool.
Yeah.
But and you have wipes if they want to get messy.
Definitely,
yes,
definitely.
Wipes are necessary when you don't have a sink, especially, right?
Hi, Ben. How are you?
Are you having fun?
Yeah.
Can you tell us what you're doing at this station? What are you observing? What are you touching?
Seeds.
And how do the seeds feel?
Cool.
Are they slimy?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think so. Would you like to introduce yourself, too, to let us know who's helping out today?
I'm Riley.
Riley, what grade are you?
11.
So we've got Riley from Westfield High helping us out. Here, I can't wait. I think the guys are kind of staring at us like, what are these people doing walking around?
Is anyone going to reach
their hand in? Is anyone going to reach in there?
Who's brave?
Who's brave enough?
Who likes to get messy? They probably will do it when we walk away.
I was
going to
say this.
They're wondering what we're doing.
Let's walk away and see what happens.
Come on over. All right. Engineering station. Look at that hard hat.
Look at the hard hat.
Amazing.
Why don't we take a minute? And you want to introduce yourself to our audience?
Sure. My name's Anik.
Anik, what grade are you in at Westfield High?
I'm in 11th grade.
Awesome. Thank you so much for coming down today and helping out our kids. This is fabulous.
Do you want to explain what the kiddos are doing at your station for us?
Yeah, so they're building a bunch of blocks and a bunch of different materials to try to build the highest tower, and then they're going to try to use one of these squashes to balance it on top.
Engineering and balancing.
They followed us here.
What?
I thought we were going away so they could play with the pumpkin, and they followed us here. All right.
I love the hat you're wearing, too. It's all about the costumes.
Have fun, gentlemen.
Okay, so this station is called Mother Nature's Collage.
Ooh. Uh-huh.
And Miss Miller took her students on a nature walk, is that right, to collect? Can you say that again?
I sent it home for them to do with their families at home, so they did it at home.
I love that homeschool connection. And so they brought their bags back, and they are making a collage.
They're making a collage with the contents of their bag. Mm-hmm. Awesome. By the way, Ms. Miller, I just want to let the general public know that I think you have the best classroom in all of Westfield Public Schools. I want to reiterate that again.
So much. I think so too.
if you ever see this room, it's incredible.
I have not seen, so I'm gonna have to visit.
You have to go because the not only the room but just the couple of times I visited, how engaged our kids are and how excited they are to be here.
Wonderful. And there's a new touch view in the room,
there
so that
is.
Makes it even better.
They love the touch view, and so do I.
Awesome. I'm a big touch view fan myself.
And we installed that for you. You're welcome.
Yeah. Awesome.
Yes. And
all right.
Would you like to introduce yourself, my friend, to our listening audience? Tell us who you are, what grade you're at, and why you're helping out the kids today.
My name is Bradley Brainerd. I'm a junior at Westfield High School, and I'm helping out the kids today because teaching kids is very important.
Yeah, and what we're very thankful that you're able to dedicate some time today. Is everybody having fun? Yeah? Yeah? What? You're having a good time? Excellent. All right.
I love how there's pine cones in here. We'll have to get the laminate over the pine cones. No, that's perfect. We're going to make it work.
Absolutely.
That stem for you. Yep. Okay, there's one station.
I was going to say, did we miss one?
Yep, right over here.
Okay.
Yeah.
How are you?
So this is called Acorn Speedway.
Oh, yes. Yeah. Acorn Speedway. I remember this one.
Yep. So this is where they're just moving these kind of tubes around and playing around with how fast the acorns travel down. And they can make different paths. And as an added bonus, how cute are these little squirrels where they can pick up the acorns?
Absolutely. Yeah.
So they have fun. Fun at this station. Usually they could stay here and play for a long time because it's open-ended play. So,
Mr. Chisholm, looks like you got a pretty fun station to work with today, huh?
You know, and it's really easy. You just tell them the squirrels have to collect the acorns and let them loose.
And they do the rest. Yeah.
Brilliant coaching on your part, Mr. Chisholm. Mm-hmm. Put your students out in the more difficult stations, and you reap the rewards of Acorn Station. I love it.
Are you having fun?
Yeah.
Yeah? Tell me what you're building.
I'm building
Are you building a speedway for your acorns?
Wow, well, this has been fun.
Yeah, so
nice experience for the
that's
kids.
That's a summary of all the stations. Do you see what I mean about the high school students having fun?
Oh, yeah.
Just as much fun as the
Oh, absolutely. Well, and we've got hard hats. We've got kids working. We got kids moving around. We've got the high school kids clearly engaged with our students. So this is such a worthwhile endeavor for both sides. Yeah, I think it's time for our next break. Ken, it's all yours, brother.
Climate change, white rhino goes extinct. Great Pacific garbage patch, time to learn.
Live from Studio 120 at Westfield Technical Academy, this is WCPC Channel 15 at 89.5 FM, WSKB Westfield.
Welcome back to Superintendent Spotlight. We are here at Highladn Elementary School during STEM Week. And just a reminder, we do STEM all year, not
That's
just
right.
during this week, but we feature it on our show. And we were, during the break, we're watching as Micah Grimsley, Mr. and Mrs. Grimsley are teachers at Westfield Technical Academy, and Micah is over there, and he's building a, he's at the engineering station, and he's building a structure. It's pretty tall, huh?
It is pretty tall. I'm interested to see how that gourd fares.
Well, the gourd, is, so the purpose is they have to build the structure, and then they have to put the gourd on top, so they're learning balance, also,
Uh-oh.
And building
skills.
Oh, no, it just came crashing down.
Micah's smiling.
But he's smiling about it, so I wonder if he knows we're talking about him because he's looking over here at us. But what a great day, huh? I mean, these kids are certainly engaged, a little shy when you shove a microphone in their face. But, you know, we all were at one point when that happened.
Well,
right?
Let's not forget they're three, too,
right?
You know,
yeah.
like maybe four, you know, so.
And they're like, who's this person putting a microphone in my face? Which, but, you know, they did talk and it was kind of. It's
oh, yeah.
Just, It's cute, but also educational, and I think it's pretty good. So can you talk a little bit about, so all of these stations are at all of our preschools, right?
Yep.
And what skills are we working on, like in general? I know STEM, but like are there any specific skills we're focusing on?
Yeah, so one of the things that's really big in science and technology, engineering, and math, and in general, is their observation skills.
Sure.
So one of the things I was working with the students on the pumpkin station with was, and actually our high school students are doing a phenomenal job of questioning.
They are.
And so they were working on like, well, what are they touching? Where is it coming from? Why is it squishy? What other properties are there of the pumpkin? One of the things they work on with the gourd is size and proportion, and you know, a lot, there's a lot of counting going on here
okay.
today, so we have a lot of that math.
The practice standards
mm-hmm.
in action. Can you talk about
those practice standards, Lauren,
yeah.
that we're seeing the content but also the practices
right.
of scientists and engineers,
right? So in the science standards, there are 8 practices, which are overarching skills
mm-hmm.
we want all of our students to have, like modeling, collecting data,
sure.
analyze, those types of things. And those are overarching and touch upon really all the things we're doing here
yes.
today. And it's that hands-on component that naturally comes to science that's really important to highlight and get kids excited. Too. That's a big part of this today, is just getting kids really excited about science, technology, engineering.
Well,
and
when we step away and aren't shoving a microphone in their face, they seem genuinely excited.
Oh,
yeah.
They really are. I mean, the kids over at the Exploding Pumpkins, they are hilarious.
I got a picture of that.
Yeah,
and coming up.
They, yeah. The baking soda and vinegar reaction is a tried and true.
Oh, it's
class
old school.
Classic.
Fan favorite.
Vintage.
But I was laughing because I was like, these dishes we were cleaning up yesterday. I was like, they'll never be cleaner because, you know, vinegar and baking mm-hmm. soda is
yep.
clean product,
great
right?
cleaner, right?
So, yeah, and then over at the fall station where they're painting, you're asking them to put their noticing and wonderings down on paper. So
it's
they're
also
noticing.
Art.
Yeah.
They're making
and
art.
You know what? Art's really important. Creativity,
right.
really important. I was just talking to my brother yesterday. He's a plastic surgeon. He had to take art classes in residency.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wouldn't know that.
Yeah.
Art, the art piece is important, and I think was you. Someone asked Lindsay or Susan, I can't remember, like what they're painting, and they said I'm painting a tree. It was just cool. The other
yeah.
station, they're still there. I think they're racing acorns or something.
Yeah.
What's going on with that?
So
that's a fun one, I think.
It is a really fun one.
Absolutely.
So
what's
they're
the goal?
Working on their they're doing some occupational
yeah, some fine
skills,
motor,
fine
sure.
motor skills too, because they're using tongs to pick up those tiny acorns, and
right.
I tried to do it yesterday. It's not that easy.
Mm-hmm.
But they're creating paths for the acorn to travel down, but they get to design them. You know, you think of like when you were a kid and you like set fake booby trap type
mm-hmm.
things with the dominoes.
Right. The Rube
you know,
Goldberg
we're just encouraging.
Machines.
Yes, we are just encouraging Rube Goldberg machines.
Yeah. Early stages.
Early stages.
Never too young.
No,
that's
but
right.
but a lot of these have multi, you know, multiple purposes.
Right.
Sure.
What's the squirrel on that one? There's a squirrel.
Yeah, the squirrel's the tongs
that's the
used
tong.
To pick up
that's
the
acorn. That's what they have to use to pick it
yeah,
up?
Yeah,
yes.
It's actually, yeah, and I,
I mean, my fine motor skills aren't the best, but they was, it's good. They're doing an excellent job.
They're doing better than adults.
They did better than me. Yeah. They sure did.
Mm-hmm. That looks a little challenging.
The students at Munger Hill really beat me out on that one.
They did?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
How about what's going on in the pop and the dancing popcorn kernels?
So that is also a baking soda and vinegar reaction.
But what does it do to the popcorn kernels? Because it was pretty cool. I mean, Chris didn't dance for us. He said he was going to. So
no, I just didn't feel. There was no music. So Lindsay and I were saying that. No, I'm being very serious. So Lindsay and I said that maybe a nice little added bonus to that station in the future would be have a little, as soon as that reaction, someone hits a little recorder, boo-doo-doo.
Oh, like, yeah.
Little music comes on.
Kids get to move.
Right, I think that's
Mr. Rogers' station.
I think
year.
So.
we're in.
He's going to help us find
that.
Yeah,
it's the chemical reaction creating the gas bubbles that are causing the popcorn.
Yeah, the pop. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So they come up and down, though, right?
Lots of chemistry. Yep.
Lots of chemistry going
on. We and love
the,
chemistry.
We do. But the students were like, I mean, we were at the table, and one of the students, when they did it, was in awe of the.
No question.
Happening with it. And of course, it bubbles up a little bit and so on. What goes into the planning of this week?
A lot.
I know.
There's a lot. We start back in August. Kate, Lindsay, and I have been meeting frequently, and it requires a coordination of not only our curriculum team, which is fantastic. I mean, Kelly O'Sullivan's at SRS with Kate Perez right now. Brian Ducco was at Munger Hill with us yesterday. So it requires a lot of hands-on, just ordering the materials. I mean, getting them in, making sure these are all set up.
Mm-hmm. And you've got more schools than ever this year to do it at.
Yeah. And coordinating the permission slips for the high school students, coordinating the busing, coordinating the transportation for them, because it's really important. The kids love it. The high school students learn a lot. One of the things, these are our biomedical students. And
I was just going to ask that.
We had three courses of our biomedical students come. So we had our biomedical anatomy students. Those are our sophomores. Mm-hmm. Our biomedical chemistry students, which are the ones here today. And then our healthcare employment students, which is our senior year capstone.
Mm-hmm.
And those students went on Wednesday.
Okay.
And one of the things we like to do that is a skill that can't be directly taught is empathy and interaction with patients. All of these students want to go in the healthcare field. And so we are working on ways to build students' capacity in working with, I mean, some of them want to go into pediatrics, some of them don't, but you still have to know how to interact. And that's why we, in the past, have partnered with the senior center, too, being able to have conversations with people that aren't in your generation.
And this is the same, I mean, this is, what kind of the training go on in the classroom to prepare those high school students to do this?
Yeah, the original stations, actually, where we started from, came from high school students.
Right.
Brainstormed them.
That's fantastic.
Yeah.
Because they're applying their knowledge that they learned, which is what
we
like to see.
We do like to see that. But also, it's a lot of skills to teach something. You know, it's a higher order thinking.
Sure.
To be able to teach something versus do it. But they, we definitely worked with their teachers, you know. One of them couldn't be here. They selected to be on a jury. But we worked with them to help prepare our students for, you know, talking to our students, talking to kids this age, explaining things like you know, don't hand them the Sharpie to write their name. They can't write their name. You write their name on the paper.
Yes.
Those types of things that you don't necessarily think about till a kid starts coloring with the Sharpie all over the paper.
On a place where they shouldn't be.
But we're, you know, and the high school students have done other things this week that have been really cool. And our engineering students have went to the Mass Mutual Center on Tuesday.
So I was going to ask about that.
Oh, it was awesome. Mass Makes, which is a big group within the state that promotes manufacturing. And they hosted at the Basketball Hall of Fame, and 13 of our students from Principles of Engineering, a Project Lead the Way class taught by Renee Sweeney, went to the Basketball Hall of Fame and participated in stations there. They were using robots to move things. They were building, they were doing engineering challenges. We won a 3D printer there.
Oh, whoa,
yeah.
I didn't know that. That's
Westfield
terrific.
Westfield State is the host of the Pioneer Valley STEM
Network.
And Dr. Kim Berman.
Very nice.
And I'm on the board with them on that, but they help fund that project. And they gave out 3 3D printers, and we were the only school from Western Mass that won one.
That is really excellent. Lauren, wow. Did we talk about the friend that you have with you today?
Oh, this is Fiona, the phenomenon flamingo.
Oh.
Science instruction in Westfield is, we are doing wonderful things across the board. My teachers will joke about how many times I can say phenomenon in a
You do
day.
Like that word.
Yeah, I do love it. But phenomenon-based instruction is what science instruction should be. And curriculums like Project Lead the Way or Open SciEd at our middle school.
What does that look like? Phenomenon-based curriculum.
For those of us who are social studies people. Or
well, it starts, you know what? You probably did this.
I'm sure I did, but you never know.
But it's actually where you start with something that piques kids' curiosity, right? Like, why is this happening? What do you notice? What do you wonder about this event? So, for example, in eighth grade, our students get a recording of a kid at a doctor explaining their symptoms. And throughout the whole unit, they're trying to figure out what's going on with this girl, McKenna. At the end, listeners at home, don't ruin it for the kids. She has celiacs.
Right.
But they get to that through a series of investigations. It's called storylining. So every investigation builds, and the kids are driving that bus. They're driving the instruction. And our teachers are masterfully facilitating mm-hmm. it. And that is really hard. And our teachers are doing a great job.
Excellent.
Yes. Yeah.
That's terrific.
It's easier to just tell the kids
sure is.
And give them all the information, but
sure.
we know that that's not the way that we engage students in their learning, and it doesn't provide the best outcomes for students in their learning. They well, need to take the cognitive
load
mm-hmm. of the work.
Right.
The
Absolutely.
Lesson.
Yeah. And the other thing is what do scientists do? Well, they do this. They look at something. They say, wow, why is that happening? And then they figure it out.
Right.
So, like, if we just stand and deliver, that's not how science, engineering, that's not how technology.
Well, it's
kind
of boring, to be fair. I mean, I'm not trying to be.
No.
But you until you get your, I mean, look, at a lot of it, a lot of us like to get our hands dirty. We want to
yeah,
know.
Absolutely.
You know, and if you tell me everything, well, that doesn't really, I'm not going to remember that as much as if I do it. And I mentioned earlier, you know, if you want to learn something, teach it. So for the high school students here, too, I mean, they are reinforcing knowledge when they're delivering it to our preschool kids, right? I mean, that's what's going on here.
Yeah, and if you bring it back to the standards, the disciplinary core idea, that's the part of the standard that, like, would be like the old standards. Mm-hmm. It would be the part that'd be like, all right, mitochondria, powerhouse of the cell type thing, you know? But with the way the standards are written is we want them to take that skill. You can Google that.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you can Google the science facts.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What you need is to know how to do science.
Sure.
How do you go through the processes and take it with you? How do you analyze data? We want to send kids into, you know, the world able to interpret, able to draw conclusions from multiple sources. And that's a everyone thing.
Right.
You know?
Absolutely.
Not just science. Yes.
Absolutely. It's 10:01.
I can't believe it.
No, we're done. and I don't want to be, but we are. So what are some closing thoughts? Anything else you want to talk about STEM Week before we wrap up today?
I just think if we just hit on the big picture here in Westfield, and that really is making sure every single one of our students, whether they want to, you know, in the future or not, to see themselves as being able to.
Right.
To be able.
Sure. We want to graduate well-rounded science so that they've had experience in the different science disciplines by the time they graduate.
Well, and removing barriers, too, for kids. Because some, if you don't do this, you might be afraid of it, right?
Right.
And I think historically what we see.
Well, and we're fighting the stigmas from TV, right, like from all around that are playing in our kids' minds.
Right.
Know?
And that's, women in STEM. That's
and I also just want to say thank you to the entire curriculum team. This has been, you know, I don't care what your title says, you are the expert in. You have, everyone has been so great.
That's great
all
to hear.
All hands on
that's
deck.
That's really
love
good
the
to hear.
Teamwork that I'm seeing, and it's terrific and starts at the top. So thank you, Mrs.
Yes.
Dyer.
Yes.
Thank sure you. Is. Thank you. And speaking of women in STEM, we were talking with Lindsay
about
your
talked about
award.
You like you weren't even here.
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
No, good catch.
Massachusetts
good catch, Mrs. Dargy.
Project Lead the Way, of the Year.
Yeah, that was really exciting. You make us proud.
That's a really outstanding honor, Lauren.
And I'm glad you were at school committee when we got to talk about
it.
Yeah, it worked out
perfect. That just worked out well.
Yeah.
All right, folks, next week we're actually not on. We are taking the week off. We're going to do a best of show. And then we come back the following week, and let me just figure out who we have.
I believe that's November, what, 2nd?
November 2nd it is, and it's you.
I think that's me.
And you're bringing some. You're bringing somebody on.
I'm bringing a couple of members of our school resource officer team in Westfield.
Yeah, we're going to talk about our safety protocols because we're going to just have come off doing the Alice drills. So we want to, you know, safety at the forefront at all times. So we won't be back. So I guess we're going to miss Halloween. We have to say happy Halloween. We're going to because we won't be back till November. But thank you. For this, thank you for your efforts here. I love seeing engaged and smiling students as I look around. You can see
there's the dancing station.
There's the dancing. Yes, I don't know. I think she wins, Kristen.
She does, without a doubt.
Absolutely.
Without a doubt.
So, all right, folks. Thank you for tuning in, and we will catch you in 2 weeks here on Superintendent Spotlight. Have a good weekend.
Have a good week, everybody.
Thank you.
Oh, that was awesome. Thank you, guys.
That can't be sold. We were right till we weren't. Built a home and watched it burn. I didn't wanna leave you. I didn't wanna lie. Started to cry, but then remembered I can buy myself flowers. Started to cry, but then remembered I